Moving on now, lawmakers tonight are very close to a compromise on banning texting while driving.
Emily Price shows us what they decided.
It is truly a compromise, a combination of the House and Senate bills. If you're a teenager, the compromise means you won't be able to use a handheld device at all. That means no talking, no reading, writing, or sending text messages. You're also not able to use any handheld games. For adults, you are still allowed to talk on your cell phone while you drive, but you will not be able to write, send, or read a text message. It looks like there will be some major exceptions for emergency workers. Right now, lawmakers are working on the wording that would allow firefighters, police officers, even some professional truck drivers to be able to read devices behind the wheel.
I think we have a rare opportunity to keep the genie in the bottle here, because we have a mounting problem, a growing problem with texting.
Lawmakers begin their conference committee meeting with optimism. After years of flirting with the texting ban, this is the closest they've ever been.
I think this is a great compromise that we're looking at here.
Close to compromise, but legal wording still needs to be put in place. The biggest area of concern is this. Banning leisure text messaging among family and friends while making sure emergency workers and professional truck drivers can still do their jobs.
A lot of them have those mounted, where they have to read to do their day-to-day work.
What's really extremely critical, especially in small rural Iowa, our volunteer fire department all carry the pager system, which in essence then becomes a handheld device.
And I think those things need to be addressed in any final bill, because if you put reading in there, I don't want to keep a fireman from responding to a fire at my house.
After all, public safety is the reason they're here. A final agreement will likely come on Thursday.
I don't think we're that far apart on it.
As we speak, they are drafting up new wording that would put this compromise on paper. Then the compromise will be circulated among lawmakers in the House and the Senate in order to gauge if there is enough support for it to pass. The committee will then meet again tomorrow morning, and they do expect and hope to have an agreement.
And there's not a lot of time left to do this.
No, there sure isn't, because it is a shorter session, which could be over by the end of the month.
Okay. Thank you, Emily.
Mm-hmm.